Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm here with a man that has masterminded this tremendous situation. And JJ, the wrestling world really basically, I know I am still in a state of shock over what has happened.
Well, Jim Ross, if you really think about it, it wouldn't be such a shocking situation because Ric Flair himself, before 1987 ever ended, went on national television and said that his personal choice for a Four Horsemen was none other than Barry Windham. And once the seed was planted, I took it from there, and for the last 3 or 4 months, I've been talking on and off with Barry Windham. And three major points that I kept bringing up to Mr. Windham is, number one, I realized that Dusty Rhodes helped raise Barry Windham. He was like a son to him. But I told Barry Windham, you can spend your whole life with this feeling of indebtedness and gratitude, and if you never get over that, you can never break away and make a life for yourself. Number two, recent months, all we heard about was television contracts, movie contracts, personal endorsements, big money. But they never mentioned Barry Windham's name, who should have been the person they were talking about. All they talked about was Lex Luger in Hollywood Lights. And the third thing was, I knew that Lex Luger couldn't cut it because he ran with us. Great athlete as he is, his priorities are somewhere else. And I told Barry Windham, I don't know when it's going to be, I don't know where it's going to be, but at some point, when you really, really need him, he's not going to be there, and then I'm going to be the one to say, I told you so, and I think that was the decisive thing. And I'd like to go back now to Jacksonville for that World Tag Team title match, and I think you'll see, Jim Ross, just exactly what I was talking about.
Barry Windham over there to check on his good friend Lex Luger, his partner. Partner's in and out of the ring. Barry there protecting his partner, but Luger has sustained two DDTs and just been nailed there on the outside.
Windham is ushered back over by Long. You see Arn Anderson with a throat against top rope. Luger rolls out one more time. He can only stand up, and a boot in the rib cage from Dillon from the blind side.
Dillon with those street shoes, leather-soled shoes, buried the point of it to the solar plexus of Lex Luger. And Luger right across the steel railing here by Arn Anderson. And once again, Barry Windham comes to the aid of his fallen comrade, his partner.
You know, Luger's taking some beatings, but right now, this is as much beating we've ever seen Luger take. And he's rolled back in the ring by Blanchard. Here's your cover. Long comes from the blind side himself and makes a two-count only.
Luger has such great strength, Tony, that instinctively he lifted himself right out of that funny predicament.
Oh, honey, right in the back row. Right across the chest, the pecs. And Luger, winded, dazed. Windham, ill-advised, comes in to help out his comrade. But there's nowhere to go except ushered back out one more time to the other side on Anderson. Goes by Buster.
This has got to be it right here.
Gosh, what power! Two DDTs and a spinebuster! The package is kicked out of it!
Blanchard now trying to... Look like he's trying to snap Mary. But Luger has reversed it! Luger's trying to get Tully Blanchard over! In a pretty predicament! His shoulders are down!
And once again, athletic ability on both sides. Those big arms wrapped around Tully Blanchard, but he got out of it. And now, wisely to the corner with a double team. Blanchard holds on. Anderson, the enforcer, comes in. Cuts off Windham with a left hand. It makes Windham mad. He's run back. And now, it is Arn Anderson at the throat.
Anderson now with a lateral press. Holding Luger down, but the referee is detained with Barry Windham. Count of two.
Barry Windham and Arnie may have helped his own cause right there because there was a long count before Teddy Long got the count. And now Luger, another, maybe a second, third, maybe fourth win, coming back, the package to his knees, to one knee, coming up, you see, Luger, trying, he's got him up against the ropes, but he's in the wrong place, Jim.
He certainly is, the tag team champions had him in their part of the ring, and now, Blanchard going for the figure four, and the massive legs of the total package. Man, this is a tense situation for the total package. I've never seen him sustain this much punishment ever in his career.
I think you're right. We said that earlier. How much more can Luger take? And we have seen when we thought he was up, the high kick out he had, it really threw on Anderson off. Luger, as you see that great athlete, Barry Windham, Luger has come back and back again. But the Horsemen are going with guns full loaded at Lex Luger right now.
This battle, ladies and gentlemen, if you just joined us here, is for the tag team championship on the line. And the challengers are Arn Anderson.
Trying to get in the ring. Blanchard missed that time. But you know, that's a purpose to that swing. It's more than just to hit Barry Windham, even though they do not connect. It's a getting mad. Get the referee's attention somewhere else. Logan reverses the suplex. Where that came from, I never know. And neither will J.J. Dillon, as you saw at the bottom of your screen. Windham trying to encourage his partner to get up.
To make the tag, and hopefully he will very soon. Barry Windham will be rested and ready. What a collision. Two great athletes. What a collision there.
Luger, Blanchard, both men staggering, trying to get up. As you see, Luger, he's up first of all.
Over there, Tony.
He is sure, and I'll be very surprised if he can even get up. Luger is down. He has not moved over there. There he goes.
He's trying to get to his feet.
Huh. Oh, they really hurt him.
Yeah, he's been lacerated. Oh, no.
But Barry Windham is the big Texan was cooking until that move by Tully Blanchard. Now, how much longer can Barry Windham hold off?
The challengers.
He cannot get to his feet.
What's he talking about?
He said, and if I can repeat that, if I think I caught it right from J.J. Lee, he said, I told you he wouldn't be there. I have no idea what he means.
He's talking to Barry. He said, Wendell, I told you he wouldn't be there. What's that mean? I don't understand that.
Trying to get him off Blanchard. This is a one-man battle. Still staggering, he is still on his knees. JJ continues to talk to Barry Windham. There may not be a man there during the time, but by golly, there's a man trying to get up and quit it.
Jim Ross, you have just seen wrestling history. And I'm sure that the sports analysts in the months and the years to come, when they reflect back on this event, this moment will be the most outstanding moment in any professional athletics this entire decade. Once again, Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson have established their dominance in tag team competition, possibly the greatest tag team ever of all times. Ric Flair continues to dominate as the world's heavyweight champion, possibly the greatest champion of all time. And Barry Windham does no need at this point to prove himself, but I know that he already has his sights on the vacant United States heavyweight title, a title that he's never held, certainly a prestigious title, and he's looking at the big tournament coming up in Houston, Texas, and that's who I'd be putting my money on. Now, there's only one shadow that looms over this entire scenario, and that is the awesome shadow of the Midnight Rider, and he must be dealt with. And I know, Jim Ross, that you have a commercial break coming up here, and I would like to beg your indulgence and stand by with you, because coming back, I would like to address the presence of the Midnight Rider.
And we'd like to hear your opinion, no doubt about it, ladies and gentlemen. We will address that situation right after this very brief timeout. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. After the big match, there was a great deal of jubilation in the Four Horsemen locker room, no doubt. But a big man dressed in all black called the Midnight Rider certainly made his presence known. I know you're not going to forget that scene.
Well, the Midnight Rider is certainly a force that has to be dealt with. Not only did the Four Horsemen feel that way, but certainly Kevin Sullivan, Jim Cornette, and Gary Hart were all in total agreement that something has to be done to stop him. You see, I know who the Midnight Rider is, and more importantly, Barry Windham knows who the Midnight Rider is. And if you would, a little food for thought, who knows the more innermost, darkest secrets of a father than his son? And Barry Windham told me himself, even though he doesn't wear a belt right now, the matter at hand is simply to take the mask off the Midnight Rider, and he told me that he feels that he would be the man to do that. Now, with all the jubilation in Jacksonville, I would like to go back to that scene, because once again, as you've already alluded, the Midnight Rider could not keep his nose out where it belonged, but when all the dust settled, Barry Windham did end up with a rather unique trophy.
Say, man, it is total shock, not only here in Jacksonville, but I'm sure nationwide, as we have witnessed the last thing in the world we expected. What in the world happened to Barry Windham? Luger was trying to get back in the ring. He did everything he could, and the Midnight Rider, I don't know where he's going, but he looks like he means business. Nikita Koloff, Dr. Death, and Sting are helping Luger out of the ring. Well, it appears that, and I understand we are going to try to follow the Midnight Rider. Jim, as we do, I think, I'm sure we have sound back there. Why don't we just let the video speak for itself here?
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and little did we know during the holidays of 1987 that the heavyweight champion of the world would make a profound statement. We hear a lot of profound things from this gentleman, no doubt about that, but what we're about to hear really strikes home right now. Before we talk to the champ, let's go back in time to Richmond, Virginia, and these famous words.
The horsemen, not the four horsemen, Ric Flair. What are you going to do about the four horsemen?
Oh, yes, we are. You know who we are. We're the four best there is. But we are taking into consideration one, Barry Windham. And Barry Windham, pal, you know what it's like to walk on the wrong side. lay the tracks. Nice guys finish last. So, pal, if JJ brings it to you, I'm talking about the contract. Be ready, because it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Well, there we hear it. Little did we know what profoundness that was. I've always admired your ability to surround yourself by outstanding talent in and out of the ring, and you have spotted the greatness in Barry Windham at that time, no doubt.
Jim Ross is a classic example of the best meeting the best. We as horsemen knew beyond a shadow of a doubt that the greatest wrestler with the greatest raw skill and pure ability in our sport was Barry Windham. And brother, he sat over there being denied the stardom and the stature that this business should have brought him long ago. So JJ, put the needle in. We made it known worldwide. We wanted him on our team. And what Barry Windham has done has made a career decision that'll take him anywhere in this sport that he wants to go. He is now a member of the most select and elite force of wrestlers in the world today. He's right here. He's one of the horsemen. He left Luger, he left Dusty Rhodes, he left the Road Warriors, he left Sting, and he came over the bridge to the big side of town. He now rides in limousines. He flies in a Learjet a mile long. He had any woman he wanted before, but now it's like this. And he has the distinct pleasure of saying that his best friends in the world are the World Tag Team Champions, Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard, and the world's heavyweight wrestling champion, Ric Flair. Barry Windham, and keep in mind, we like everybody in this force to have all the trophies available in this sport. There's one trophy missing to make this collection complete. It's the U.S. title. And Barry Windham, for all that raw power, for all that great ability, pal, you now will become one of the dirtiest players in the game. And anybody out there that doesn't think we mean business, you take a look at us from this point on, because we got a point to make.
It's a very emotional time and a very difficult time for this man right here, the total package, Lex Luger. We know you have not seen the tape of what happened losing the World Tag Team belts. Why don't you take a look at it right now and tell us in your own words, as we show everybody the tape, what you were thinking as this was going on, Lex.
Well, Tony Schiavone, I had been able to watch on my monitor back here, and it's a very difficult thing to watch. Me and Barry said we were going to be the fighting champions of the world. Here we are 3 weeks later doing just what we said we're going to do. That is fighting the former champions right here on national TV. Now, at the time when I made the tag, Arn Tully, I admit they had me in a very bad way. I kept on fighting. If you were going to help me, I felt if I gave it to Barry, who was the fresh man, a real chance to win this match and retain our titles. On the tag, as we all saw, from seeing it back now, I got a knee in the back. I took a hard bump to the floor. Tully Blanchard ended up rolling out, gave me a hard boot to the gut, and he busted me open on the post, and that's when things got very fuzzy for me personally, because I went unconscious there for a while. And the next thing I saw was that I could see the guard rail. I knew Barry, I knew the match was still going on, I could hear the crowd. I was very woozy. I made my way over the guard rail, hoping that I could use the guard rail to be able to get back to our corner and help out some way if I could. Now, at this point here, I made my way on the guardrail. I've been lacerated pretty badly. And the blood was down my eyes. I had trouble seeing. But I knew I had to get back up to my corner. And right here, as you see, I'm trying to crawl back up. At this point here, I didn't know this was Barry Windham, Tony. I never saw him here. I knew somebody picked me up here and threw me in the ring. I was half out of it at this point. But as I rolled over, I didn't know what was going on. I thought the match was over because I saw Barry Windham's boots, his wrestling boots. I thought the match was over here. I didn't know what was going on. I tried to pull myself up to stand up with Barry. And as you can see right here, this is where I put my legs up for good.
Off right there, did you know it was Barry that hit you right there after you stood up?
it's hard to comprehend at the time. You know, I saw Barry coming at me, but it just was, I couldn't believe it was Barry Windham. But, you know, it's irrefutable right here on videotape. And you got to say, there's no doubt about it, it was Barry Windham. And it's just incomprehensible, Tony, it really is.
There it is, out cold, no doubt about it. And Barry Windham walks out.
You know, it's been an emotional roller coaster for me. It's been almost 2 weeks since this thing happened, Tony. But I'll say one thing. I've come to grips with it. You watch the tape. There's no refuting it. Barry Windham is the Four Horsemen. But Barry Windham, you look into my eyes. You think you're amongst friends. But you have just chosen the loneliest path you have ever set out on in your life. Because Lex Luger, if it's the last thing I do on this planet Earth, I'll make sure it's along this road you have ever traveled.
The unit is intact here, ladies and gentlemen. But Barry, I want to say that you were the last man that I ever thought would become the newest horseman. Not because of your athletic ability, but because of your
velocity.
Let me
tell you something, Lex Luger, you seem to think that I'm going to be walking a lonely path. Well, let me tell you something, pal. I chose where I am because I want to be here. And look at the company that I'm going to keep. I've got the Nature Boy, Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, and the best, the foremost manager in professional wrestling today. I'm running with the most elite group of gentlemen that there are. And I am going to be the best that there is in professional wrestling. Myself. Step on in here, Nate, and let them know.
The symbol of excellence.
And that's all I got to say. The bottom line is, you're looking at the best this sport has ever had to offer. Our total package. Woo!